From despair to repair, that's what the Lord is doing in the lives of individuals. You'll be able to hear their testimonies, that and much more. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. God is moving in a mighty way. We're seeing Him just work in lives. People that were at the point of despair, people came to us homeless. John, you were one of those. And the Lord, through His Holy Spirit, has begun to repair your life. What's God doing in your life?
Excellent. Thanks, Reverend Rice.
You came to our facility in Potosi.
Is that first?
Was it first Springfield, right? Then you went to Potosi and then back to Springfield. Is that correct?
That's correct.
All right. Tell us about how your life was despairing at that point.
I was on the streets and it's hard to get a job when you're on the streets, no matter what everybody says. It's a little bit harder than everyone says it is. And I decided I'd join the program for 2 years and see where that got me. So far, it's going excellent.
How has it changed your life?
Learning more about Jesus, my Savior, and just leadership, being more of a leader, you know, and becoming more outspoken and stuff like that.
And that's what you are doing. Lives are changing, brothers and sisters, because of you. And I'm asking you to go to God and believe God with us for a miracle. I thank God for those who are being a part of a miracle. During this Labor Day season, what we're doing during this Labor Day weekend is believing God for $100,000. Already individuals have come forth and said, we're going to be matching gifts. Those who call in during your Labor Day telephone, we want to match. And so as we get ready for moving into Labor Day, the days leading up to it, we're giving people an opportunity to get directly involved. I thank God for those who are matching gifts. Louis Gabriel, $7,000 from Alton, Illinois. So let's get that match, brothers and sisters. Will you do it? Your gifts are being matched dollar per dollar. So I want to encourage you to get up and go to the phones right now and call. The number's 436-2424. We have phone operators that are here, and I want to encourage you to be a part of the miracle that God is doing at this hour. The number's 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. We call it our labor of love telephone, helping to move from despair to repair. And that's in the lives of individuals, as well as even some of the buildings that we're trying to get fixed up. Yes, we're seeing God move in a mighty way. Yes, there's principalities and powers that are out there that would love to have us just leave the people out on the streets, whether it's in Springfield or St. Louis. They battle thick and thin. I mean, they just do everything they can to try to discourage us from helping and providing shelter, a place for people to sleep at night. And unless you've ever been out there, unless you've ever been out there trying to just find a place to lay your head at night, you have no idea what it's like. Did you have a hard time finding a place to sleep before you came to us in Springfield?
A little bit.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Some of the problems you encountered, what were they?
Most of the police.
Police say you can't sleep here, you can't sleep there?
Yep.
And really, the Justice Department says that when police do that, it's a violation of the Eighth Amendment concerning, cruel, unusual punishment. But the police know they can get away with it, whether it's in Springfield, St. Louis, St. Louis County. So they go on and do it. And who's that poor homeless person to fight with them? They just lock them up and harass them. So what we do is we have to step up to the plate and say, look, this is what the Word of God says. We're supposed to try to help them. We're supposed to be there for those that are hurting and in need. And that's what we're trying to do here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And there's so many individuals who are coming to us at this time. John, you indicated it's changing your life.
Yes.
It's changing your life. You're drawing closer to Jesus?
A lot closer.
Well, John's not alone. There are many others, many just like Daryl.
My name is Daryl Blair, and so many people like me work hard, and it's still, anything could happen. I just lost my job, and eventually I lost my place. I've never been homeless before, Family I couldn't depend on, and without this place, I'll be out in the street, No ifs, ands, or buts. That's just a reality, And now I get the chance to get some more work, have a place to lay down and rest. We'll have to worry about my belongings, and that's a major plus, because like I said, my job didn't want me to bring everything in, and it's hard dragging your belongings around the city, trying to look for work and trying to work, so it's tough. And there's a lot of people out there that are much worse off than I am. So, it's real tough. I don't know what to do without this place. I don't know what you guys are gonna do. It's just, times is hard for everybody, and like one guy told me, you're just one paycheck away from being down here. You never know, anything could, your job could fold up, hours can get cut, I never thought I'd be here, never, No disrespect to this place, I just never thought I'd be in this position, because I've always worked to try to maintain my own. And even that right now is just not good enough, you know. I can't afford to get into certain housing, so I'm looking for the low-income housing. You know, times is really hard. And without the shelter, there's a lot of people going to be affected. You know, I look out there and see them every day, and that's the reality of it. A lot of people are going to be homeless and nowhere to go, really, truly nowhere to go.
We must keep the New Life Evangelistic Center open. I received a letter from this downtown developer. He's put together this community organization that's threatening that if you don't get those homeless out of there, we're going to sue you again. Well, look, we're going to continue to stand steadfast. And I thank God for those of you that have a compassion for the poor and the homeless and the hurting, those of you that take serious the scriptures, those of you are willing to side with Lazarus rather than the rich man and are going to the phones and calling right now, tell New Life Evangelistic Center, make the repairs, get the permits it needs for facilitate 1411 Locust. In addition to that, pay legal expenses. Thank you, Lewis, for your matching gift. He's matching these gifts dollar per dollar. Donna Hebert, thank you for your $50 gift. See, her $50 gift becomes a $100 gift now because of Lewis's match. And then we got Michael Stevens sharing a $50 gift from Florissant. It's actually a $100 gift. So we need you to partner with us right now and go to the phones and call. The number's 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Tell us your name.
My name is Donna.
Donna, how important is it that this place is open for you?
It's given me stability in the time of being homeless and looking, reaching out for community and shelter. So I'm really appreciative that this place was open for me.
I mean, we had 68 women and children. I mean, so many children are starting to come in now the other night. And if we'd have cut to 35 people, we'd have had to put the women and children out, half of them, and all the men, they would have had no place to go. Brothers and sisters, something's wrong with that. We have 60 people just in our training programs here, and I need you to go to the phone. This is a battle. It's a matter of life and death for many of the people that come to us, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It is.
And that's why we need them to go to those phones.
Exactly. We need those the donations to come in so we can continue to be here and to get stable back on our feet and doing the thing what the Lord wants us to do at this particular time.
Now, you were in an initial 30-day program. You're moving into an intermediate program.
Yes.
Being in those programs, is it helping you draw closer to God? How is it helping you?
It's helping me continue to have a strong faith and knowing that He brought me here for a specific reason and that the things that I'm going through is just a temporary storm right now and that I'm getting through it and I'm getting through it with community and family here.
We thank God for the advocates that are standing with us at this time and the prayer warriors that are praying for us, don't we?
Yes, every day. That is something that's really wonderful and it's been happening in my life more and more.
And brothers and sisters, I'm asking you to partner with us. Go to the phones. Let us know that you're praying right now. Let God's light and love flow through you. And I thank you, Louis Gabriel from Alton, Illinois, for matching these gifts. He's doing a $7,000 initial match. And Michael, thank you for sharing your gift, a $50 gift that actually has become $100 now because it's matched. And Donna, thank you for your gift. $50 becomes $100. I'm asking you to get up and go to the phones and call right now. We're going to go to Jamal Rogers, and she's going to talk about this issue of homelessness, how critical it is that people recognize that there's a tremendous need. But first, I want to ask you another question or so. Through all this, you said you are drawing closer to God.
Yes, that is correct. Through my daily walk with Him and talking and praying with Him every day, He is supplying my needs, and I know that's something that He will provide for me regardless. So.
And anybody could end up homeless. The last brother, Daryl, he was saying people one paycheck away from actually finding themselves in that situation.
Yes, that is correct. That was pretty much the same thing for me, falling on a hard time and dealing with family that weren't understanding. So I am grateful for being here and having that opportunity for being here.
Without a place to sleep at night. I mean, sleep is such a basic necessity for human beings. And again, the Department of Justice said it's cruel and unusual punishment what's taking place in all these municipalities. You mentioned the 90 municipalities in St. Louis County. You can mention Belleville. You can mention Collinsville. You can mention Springfield after night when they just say you can't sleep here. You got to keep moving on. Cruel and unusual punishment happens every day. Same time, local police get away with it. And the reason they do that is because there's that thin blue line where we expect the police to provide all the psychiatric help. We provide expect these unbelievable things we expect from the police, and it's not fair to the police. What does it take? It takes community people who are willing to stand up and churches doing what Jesus told us to do. He said, when I was a stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? Jesus, Matthew 8:20 said, fox have holes, birds have nests. He, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay His head. He identifies with the poor, the needy, the homeless. You know the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Which side are you going to side with? The rich man that don't want the people in their neighborhood or Lazarus? You know where Lazarus went? He went to heaven. The rich man went to hell. Well, folks, come on. Let's get with it. Let's partner. Let's work together. We're working to help save lives and move people from despair to repair. And again, your life would be pretty much different right now if it hadn't been the place was open to you, wouldn't it?
It would be different right now. And I'm just grateful again for the doors being open and welcoming in and having a fellowship here and walking in the Lord every day. I'm very grateful for that every day of my life.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
For your your help. You're over here on the phones,
yes,
aren't you?
Yes.
All right, we're going to let her go back over to the phones as we go. Jamal, I want you to please join us at the phones here. Remember, your gifts are being matched dollar per dollar. You share $100, it's worth $200. We need you to believe God with us for a $100,000 miracle during this Labor Day weekend. Will you please believe God with us? I thank God for those advanced gifts. I thank God for those that are standing up at this particular moment. We need to hear from you. The number again is 436-2424. Jot that down there. Remember that, 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Please don't wait. Please get involved, and please do it right now.
One of the things I think we would be happy to see if there was no homelessness. Mm-hmm. So we need to work our way out of that situation, but you don't do that by closing down a much-needed shelter. So you have to eliminate poverty and homelessness first and then close the shelters down. It shouldn't be the other way around, because just because you close it down doesn't mean homelessness has ended. And so I think for the conditions that create homelessness, whether it be lack of mental health services, whether it be jobs or lack thereof, because people don't know that there are folks who have jobs that work that are still homeless. So there's something wrong with that picture. If you work in two or three little jobs and you still can't pay rent somewhere, that's a problem. And so these are structural issues that have to be dealt with. And targeting New Life Evangelistic Center is not going to get us to where we need to be. We need to eliminate poverty and homelessness. So I'm here to support the telethon for the New Life Evangelistic Center, and I hope you will join me in making donations. Please give us a call by using the number on the screen. Your donations are very important to keeping New Life open and responsive to the needs of our citizens who find themselves in the situation of being homeless. Thank you for your
Thank you,
support.
Jamal. God bless you. And I have with me another guest. Tell us your name.
James.
James, you're just telling me before we went on that you never thought you'd end up homeless. A friend put you out. You had nowhere else to go. You were walking the streets, and another homeless person told you about this place?
Yes, sir.
You said you spent a night out on the streets. What is it like sleeping out on the streets?
Very scary, was actually.
Where'd you sleep?
Just really didn't even sleep at all. Just walked up and down the street.
Did you experience sleep deprivation?
Yes, I did.
What happens when you experience sleep deprivation? What happens to you as a human being?
Your body shuts down.
Does it shut down? And some people get so desperate, so frustrated, that they actually engage in breaking laws. And if you leave them out there long enough, we know of even those that have committed suicide by cop, some that have gotten so desperate, so upset, so angry, so frustrated, run at a cop with a knife, they get shot. Brothers and sisters, our police shouldn't be put in that particular situation. Our police shouldn't be having the ones that have to be the ones get called all the time because churches won't open their doors, because people will back down, because they let local municipalities dictate to them, telling them you can't sleep here. You can't open that. We've got a shelter that takes in hundreds of hurting and homeless people. And local politicians are trying to stop us now. Developers are trying to stop us. We have attorneys that are keeping us open. We need your help right now. They must be paid. We also now have applied for a permit, and we have architects that have come forth. We had to file a federal lawsuit just to find out from the city of St. Louis what's involved in opening a shelter. And Brother Ray had to go down there, apply for the shelter, and they'd be telling him something different every time he applied. So he recorded their conversation and let him know later he recorded it. That made him very angry because they want to change their story every time whoever goes in to try to discourage people, stop them from opening and doing what Jesus told them to do. We're not going to let them do that. So we actually depositioned the building commissioner, depositioned the building inspectors, found out what was really needed in order to open a shelter. Then we started going through that process. We started doing that the last few months. We have an architect that's working and going back and forth. Well, we found out already. They want us to put a different heating system in each room to regulate the temperature. They want a sprinkler system in every room. They want all these things being done. They want us to take a building that's 100 years old and bring it up to 2009 codes. I mean, a lot of stuff. We're trying to work with them. And there are impossible demands that would come along and say, okay, we can only take them in your worship studio during extreme cold weather. We'll have to return to federal court on those issues if that continues to take place. We're trying to work with them, but we've got to do everything we can to see that people do not have to sleep outside. You're hearing from the adults, and so many children come to us that we didn't even get to record them. Just imagine the children that are out there. The children that are out there. It's hard for you. What if you had a bunch of children you had to take care of? and do that same.
It'd be much harder.
Really was. Was this an answer to prayer when you came here and they said, welcome, come on in?
Yes, it was.
So other homeless people told you this was the only place for you?
Yes, sir.
All right. You're hearing. We're bringing the people right to you. Go ahead. You want to say something else?
It was actually a true blessing to me that once I found this place and got in, it was, I mean, I was totally blessed.
You're getting involved in a transitional housing program right now. Your dreams, goals, plans for the future?
To get closer to God and to hopefully get back to where's almost all my family's at.
All right. Brothers and sisters, you help them realize their dreams. And I thank God for those that are going to the phones. Gary Detherian from Higby, Missouri, thank you for sharing your $15 gift. Remember, I was sharing with you earlier how Luz is matching these gifts up to a total of $7,000 this. Then we have others that are matching large amounts on this. Praise God for those of you that are getting involved. Gary, thank you. Your $15 gift has become $30. We want to encourage you to call in right now. 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. That's 1-800-334-3276. You can go online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Chandra Eagleston, thank you so much for sharing from your heart as to what it means to be a part of what God is doing here at New Life Evangelistic Center and how it's given you another chance. And she has that chance because of those of you that are opening your heart and home, those of you that are getting directly involved, those of you partnering with New Life Evangelistic Center. Her parents passed away. Loneliness, depression haunts her, but she now has a family. A family here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Don't let those rich and powerful folks shut this family down. Don't let those developers and those politicians stop us from doing what God has called us to do. Provision of shelter is a function of worship. We're practicing what we believe the Bible tells us to do. Will you stand with us at this time? Don't close your heart. Please open your wallet. Please go to the phones. Please call. Please share right now.
My name is Chandra Eagleston. I came to New Life Evangelistic Shelter because I had no home. My parents died, and I don't know why the house was locked up. I don't know why it wasn't in my name. I thought I could come pick up the house. I couldn't. So I had no place to go. And I'm still working on the case, and I'm still with a lawyer. So in the meantime, I have no place for shelter. It's very important that New Life is here. It's like divine intervention. And until I get the project solved, I'll be at New Life, and I'll improve my job information and get a lot of things done to move forward. New Life Evangelistic Shelter is very helpful to take in the sick and shut out, people who have no place to live, no food to eat, no clothing, no transportation. For that purpose alone, we'd like you to send all your donations to New Life Evangelistic Shelter. Grace be to God that you reach out to us, give us a helping hand, help keep the doors open. It's the most important thing to do in the world to pick someone up off the ground and help them start a new life. And that's what New Life is about. That's what this shelter is about. We need your donations to keep the door open for any project as major as important as that.
Please help them start a new life. That's what it's all about. Please don't let them do this to the homeless and the hurting. Stand up and be counted. Let your voice be heard. What will you say to Jesus on the day of judgment when he says, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, visit me? A stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? So often you've done to the least of these, even so you've done to me. When you solve a need, many people turn these channels. They don't want to see the need. They don't want to hear the need. You're seeing, you're hearing, you're experiencing. Be a part of what God's doing at this time. How is it helping you? How is it saving your life, Shirley?
It saved me. It keeps me from being out there in the street, raped, beat up, you know, hungry.
Shirley, you didn't have no place at all.
No.
Yes, and Shirley, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
How old are you?
62.
Well, you look younger, but I knew that you might have been over 50, but you're looking good. But Shirley, when you get to be 60, and I'm up in that area too, okay, it gets harder, doesn't it, Shirley?
Yes, it does.
It does.
Yes,
it does. It's harder. People don't realize that. You know, you're out there, and I mean, 62, too young for Social Security, and people don't hire, and you're trying, and you're trying. You lived your whole life. You don't have a place to go. I don't think people understand, do they, Shirley?
No, they don't.
They don't.
They don't care.
Yeah. How do you deal with that when they don't care?
Yeah, I just take it to the Lord in prayer.
Shirley, how's it? been for you here? You got a family here?
No, just myself.
And how about here at New Life Evangelistic Center? You feel like some of these people are family to you?
They are.
They are, Shirley?
They're all I have right now.
They're all you have right now.
That's all I have right now.
And we didn't have these Karen people out here fighting with us and in court against the rich folks that don't want you and other hurting homeless people in the neighborhood. And we just said, we can't help you, Shirley. What would happen to you?
I don't know.
I don't know.
And I really don't know. I just be out in the street.
And like you said, you can be beaten, raped, killed out there.
Yeah.
Shirley shouldn't be sent back to the streets. She's a child of God. These are God's children. Brothers and sisters, if you've got an ounce of human compassion, will you join us? We've got people that are matching your gifts right now. God has shown you so much love. Will you go to the phones and will you call? Will you pledge right now so we can continue to pay the legal bills that are here, make the repairs, get the permits, do what needs to be done? We not only have the facility here at 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis that we're fighting to keep open. We also have our Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. Training program in Marshfield, Missouri, Joplin, Missouri, New Bloomfield, Missouri, Columbia, Missouri, Potosi, Missouri, Van Buren, Missouri. People are hurting. And I want to ask you to get up and go to the phones and call. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Nancy and Michael, thank you so much. Nancy and Michael Pavlo, Eureka, Missouri, sharing a $50 gift. It's actually worth $100. Thank you, because of Lewis's matching gift here. We praise God for people that are partnering with us at this hour. We need you to partner with us, brothers and sisters. There are many people, like Sister Shirley here, that this is their home, this is their family. And you see, we're involved in a spiritual battle. Devil's mad because God's working in your life.
Yeah.
Devil's mad because souls are getting saved. Devil's mad because these babies aren't being left down the street. You see these babies and their mamas coming in, don't you, these kids?
Yes.
So many of them every night.
Yes.
And they would just have us turn them away. Talk about cruel and unusual punishment. That's what they want us to do because they don't want those folks in the neighborhood is what they say. Mm-hmm. Something wrong with that. You talk about bigotry. You talk about hostility. Homelessness become the new N-word in America today, hasn't it?
Yes.
And they think they can do just about what they want, just call you homeless.
Yes, kick us in the street.
Kicked in the street.
If it wasn't for you, we really wouldn't have no place to go, because other shelters don't let us in.
They're always full, aren't they?
Yes.
And that's what they want us to do. Establish a low number, tell them you're full, send them back out on the street. At one point, we were engaging in a reconciliation proposal for months. We begged the city and say, look, we'll reduce our numbers, but give us a number we can call. You'll come pick them up, and you'll see that people like Shirley, individuals like Shirley, children of God like Shirley, don't just end up out there suffering somewhere. They never do it. Never do it. Never make that guarantee. Just want us to send them away. Oh, brothers and sisters, oh, we've got to pray for these individuals, that their souls might be saved, their hearts might be touched. Thank God for those of you that are sharing, so individuals like John and others could get a second chance. And surely not only got a place to sleep tonight, but a home because of those of you that are partnering with us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center.
My name is John Rowe. I've been a Christian since I was 23. 7 years into being a Christian, I realized that I had a problem with drinking. It was a little hard to realize that when I was in the Navy and everyone was a heavy drinker around me. And I wasn't really having any major life problems that you would associate with drinking. I paid my bills, I took care of my family, my kids, I had a good job. I didn't have those bad problems with drinking, other than I drank a lot, I got drunk to get drunk, I would pass out, I'd get up, go to work, and come home and do it again. And so I realized I had a problem with drinking, and it required that I get much closer to God and just be true with Jesus and thankful for His freeing powers from all of our problems in order to get straight and overcome the addiction to alcohol, which was a really tough, strong addiction. I, at the same time, helped some other Christians who had been struggling with stronger addictions with opiates, heroin, and such. A good friend of mine who had been a weightlifter, and he took a fall off of a high building and broke his back. And he ended up getting addicted to heroin as a painkiller. But he was ashamed of how weak he was in the face of that drug. And he turned to me as a source of strength. At first, he didn't admire the fact that I had had the addiction to alcohol and I overcame it. But there was one day when he came on by on his motorcycle and was just looking for someone to talk to. And he started shaking real bad, going through the withdrawals. And he said to me, I don't know how you can even stand me. And I said, Doug, just about 6 weeks ago, that was me in the same spot right there on my living room rug doing the same thing, shivering, getting rid of the addiction to alcohol. And that's when he realized that an addiction is an addiction is an addiction. And Jesus can set you free from all of it.
John came. He was part of our Veterans Coming Home program. In St. Louis, we have it. We have it in Springfield. And now he's in his own place. And we just thank God for miracles because of those of you that are sharing with us. Another brother who's in the Job Corps lost his place. And I think your counselor at Job Corps told you about this place?
Yes, sir. Told me about this place about a couple weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And told me just come on in. So they accepted me in a program. I'm in a 30-day transitional program, you know, just trying to get myself together.
That's great. How's it helped you?
I mean, it helped me a lot. You know, God sent me blessings every day, and I never know it. So I had to have that faith to for God to keep holding me on every day, and you know, don't lose no train of thought of Him.
Help people understand that have never been homeless before. What's the hardest thing about being homeless?
Usually trying to find somewhere to stay. That's the main thing.
Now you got a place, don't you?
Yes, sir.
And we thank God He's got a place because of those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center right now. So I want to encourage you to follow me over to these phones over here. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Let's see who's getting involved here. Donald Sproul, thank you for sharing your $100 gift. And he's going to be praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center also. Really appreciate that. And also Judith Hunter. She's sharing a $100 gift, and these gifts are being matched dollar per dollar, so that $50 gift becomes actually worth $100 here to us at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and the $100 gift becomes worth $200. And what a blessing it is just to know that there's people out there like you who are willing to partner with us at this great time of need here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And I was really glad to see that you all are praying for us too. We really do need prayer warriors at this time. And if you'll just call and let us know, hey, I'm praying for you. The number is 436-2424, 1-800-334-3276. Let this be more than just a barbecue and celebration on Labor Day. Come on, do your part. Know that as we approach Labor Day, that you are part of a labor of love, that you did your part to help provide for so many people that literally have nowhere else to go. And as we're involved in this major battle against these principalities and powers at this time, that you have done your part so that we see that everyone has a place to sleep at night. I don't want anyone to have to sleep outside. I don't want anyone to have to be pushed from place to place. I don't want anyone to have to experience the cruel, unusual punishment that we see taking place all over in all our municipalities. As they say, you can't sleep here, you can't sleep there, you just got to keep on moving. Try to go without sleep for a few hours, even a few days, and see what happens to you. Well, brothers and sisters, it's time that we let God's light and love move in us and through us, and we feel what these women and these men are feeling at this time, and let's join in helping to keep 1411 Locust open to them.
My name is Ivy Faulkner, and to me, being here has really been a blessing to me because I don't have any parents. I don't have any close family. So it's really just me and the Bible and Jesus and prayer, as the Evangelist family here has been working with me. And I really appreciate their love and their attention. I'm not a perfect person. I mean, I've had my bad days as well as my good days. But I'm willing to work hard. Please donate to New Life Evangelistic Center because there are great people here who need, you know, love and support, and they are here for you.
My name is Rodney Wise. I feel it's important because a lot of people need help, and then hanging out in the streets ain't helping you. You know, you have to come somewhere anywhere they can help you and get you some help. And I feel it's a good place because I'm trying it out myself. Because I need some help.